Hi, I'm Justin from LUMA. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to create a human-centered design work session using the Session Planner tool in LUMA Workplace.
To begin planning your session, head to lumaworkplace.com. Sign in and click My Workplace on the main navigation bar, then click Plan a New Session. The first step when you begin a new session in Session Planner is to give your session a name and define the goal or purpose. The name and goal should reflect the outcomes you're hoping to achieve. Be sure to mention the goal and refer back to it during the session. After typing in your name and goal, click the Create the Session button. Here you'll find three methods that we recommend to start with. Read the description and choose the one that seems to fit your challenge. Abstraction laddering will help you ensure that you're focused on the right problem. Stakeholder mapping will help you understand who has a stake in your problem landscape. The cover story mock-up will help you envision what success might look like. Just click Add to add one to your agenda. Each time you add a method to your agenda, Session Planner will display three additional methods to consider using next based on the previous method you chose. You could click Add to add one of these, or click the red Add button here to add any of the 36 methods from the LUMA system, a break or meal, or other activity like a presentation. If your session is longer than an hour, consider adding a break in the middle. Next, click Details to learn how to facilitate the method. You can add notes or change the existing description to fit your situation. You can click any line, click Enter on your keyboard, and type in whatever you would like. As you build the session, pay attention to the time allotted. Each method will automatically populate with the suggested time, but you can change it if you'd like. Just click on the duration. You can change the time. Next, click Check My Agenda at the top. Here you can read advice from our instructors and coaches in the form of roses, thorns, and buds, one of our 36 methods, about the structure of your agenda. We'll point out aspects of your agenda that are positive, negative, or have the potential to improve. For example, if your session has too much or too little time planned for any given method, Session Planner will let you know. After checking your agenda, consider sharing your session plan with collaborators so they have an idea of what to expect. You can click the paper airplane icon at the top, click the simple or detailed agenda, then click copy. Then just paste the link in whatever types of communication you use, whether it's email, instant messaging apps, or something else. If you'd like to open the method in a remote collaboration tool like Mural, Miro, or Klaxoon, click the method, then you'll see a Use Template Now button on the next screen. Or you can click Materials List, and on this tab, you'll find a list of materials for the human-centered design method you've chosen. You can print the list to have as you gather the items, and you can download any of the activity templates that you're planning on using. Next, we highly recommend doing a practice run or two of your session. Click Facilitation Guide to view tips from LUMA's expert instructors and coaches to help you successfully facilitate the method. Now you're ready for a productive and effective human-centered design work session tackling your company's problem. Be sure to take photos or screenshots with participants' permission and save all your artifacts as reference materials for the work that emerges from your session. If you need additional help designing your session, start a conversation with us on LUMA Workplace. We're happy to help.
Thanks for taking a few minutes to watch this video. I hope you have a great session.